Talk radio will actually educate, inspire, and make you think. The future is now. Topics and music that affect your life from Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at UBNRadio.com.
Okay, buddy.
Live. We clear?
3, 2, 1.
Welcome to Universal Broadcasting Network's hit afternoon show, bringing you the latest in music news, artist interviews, and more with your hosts, Lauren Dare Owens, Ariel Fournier, and Adam Lusk. This is The Music Project.
It's Lauren Dare Owens.
It's Adam Lusk.
And Ariel Fournier.
And this is The Music Project. We have a very busy show today.
Woohoo.
So I think we just need to like start. I think that there's no time to talk. We have to like fit so much
Lauren,
music into
Lauren, quit stalling. You're stalling right now.
Then introduce the band.
So today we have an amazing band, one of my favorites. I love covering them on bass. It's pretty nice. We got Colorblind in the studio.
Hey.
Woo!
What's up, guys?
Hey. Awesome. How are you guys doing today?
We're doing excellent.
We're doing great.
Yay. Well, so tell us how you guys all met each other.
Well, we all go to the same high school. So I actually took a music class freshman year. It was actually called choir.
A music class.
Called choir.
Choir.
And then, so like they asked me, they're like, hey, this kid named Taylor plays drums. So I thought it was a girl at first because you know, the name Taylor. So then we met in the music class and we formed a band. But then we had another bass player before.
But some issues came up, so.
Yeah, some issues came up, and then that's how we met Michael.
Who's clearly better, right?
The better bass
player. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Clearly sexier, too. So, like. So then, like, we kind of asked him as a joke. We're like, hey, do you want to be in our band? And he's just like.
As a joke?
Yeah. We were all
hey,
in the
dude,
same
boat. You want to be in my band?
But not really.
Just kidding.
Just kidding. No.
He was kind of just like, sure. It was just kind of like, yeah, sure. Like, you know, like, we were just all in the same bio class, and he sat at our table. So we're like, hey, do you want to be in a band? He's like, yeah. So then that's how it started.
Wow.
Nice.
That's so, like, such an interesting way to meet. Is one of you colorblind, or how did that come about?
Actually, my brother is colorblind.
Really?
He kind of, like, came up with the name. Yeah, because he's colorblind. None of us are colorblind.
Let's just take a mental disorder.
My mom tried making it have some like meaning. My mom's like, because you guys aren't racist or anything. Colorblind, you know?
Because you guys aren't racist.
Because you guys aren't racist.
You know, all united.
Hey guys,
you
we're
don't
colorblind,
see colors.
Not racist. Not racist. We're going to play music now.
Everyone is one color.
Wow.
Everyone's one color.
Like, well, you know how like everyone has their own political message, like you two and everyone like that? You can just be, we're not racist.
You know, I find that really annoying.
That's our slogan.
That really annoying.
Like every band has like their little symbol or slogan or whatever. We're not racist.
No, just not racist.
Not racist.
Colorblind. Not racist.
There you go.
And then you have to do the fundraiser after like four albums and you raise a ton of money so people won't be racist.
We're
guys,
fighting racism.
Let's stop racists.
Racist?
All around the world.
Kind of a hard word to say.
Racist.
I almost messed up.
Racist. Right? Yeah.
Racism.
So tell us a little about your music and who your main influences are and who inspires you.
You want to start with Michael?
why is there laughter on that?
All right,
inside joke.
What was the question?
Influences. Who helps you
write
your music?
Our influence. Well, we cover some bands like Black Keys and Blink 182. Yeah,
That's really wide.
that's
like very general. It's very broad.
Just like anything popular.
Well, like Michael's like, he doesn't really like listen to a lot of rock music.
How about you like? How about
what
this?
Do you
how, about,
to?
How about we do your personal influences, not as a band, just who personally inspires you?
I like Flea.
Yeah.
Best bass player in the world.
Wait, what is with this? None. You're like, oh God.
How do you feel about the whole Super Bowl thing? Did you hear about that?
Oh, yeah. About them unplugging.
Well, did you see what Flea?
If
you really do enjoy Flea's bass skills.
Oh,
did you see the message?
Yeah,
he
posted.
Yeah, I saw it too.
I mean, come on.
Did
like,
you see it?
If you were playing the Super Bowl, I understand. Messing
well, like,
up in front of that many people.
Well, no. What it was is they were like, yeah, this the NFL was like, there's just too many things that we got to do. Mm-hmm. We're just going to have you guys play.
Unplugged.
Yeah,
I still
unplugged.
Thought it was awesome, though.
And then so the guys were like, no, normally we don't do that. But... You know, for the Super Bowl, this is, you know, once in a lifetime type of thing.
I mean, their guitar player could have toned it down a little
I
bit.
I know.
It was pretty obvious when he was playing.
Yeah, when I was
like moving the whole thing, like, how could you possibly play, man?
When I was watching it the first time, I was sitting there thinking, like, how the heck is he hitting those notes?
Especially during the solo when he was doing that. I'm
and
like, how is he doing that?
I was like, his guitar is behind him.
Yeah.
And flinging around, what the heck?
Well, if you notice, right in the beginning, Flea's hands aren't even on the bass; he's already playing.
Oh, really?
He's like, yeah. This, oh wait, no.
This is my feeling about it. I mean, there was pictures that went around of One Direction because they play instruments,
he
had an electric guitar not plugged in, and they're like, it's okay because that's not their thing. But Red Hot Chili Peppers got a bunch of crap for it when they're playing one of the biggest shows you could possibly play.
One Direction all the time, Red Hot Chili Peppers.
I don't
once.
Care. I still love the Red
Yeah,
Chili
I don't. I don't care. I
that was like that was awesome.
Yeah. Well, back to inspirations.
Yeah.
Taylor.
Speaking of Red Hot Chili Peppers, Chad Smith,
yes.
Really good drummer. Travis Barker, Blink-182.
Yes.
And Dennis Chambers and Tony Roaster Jr. and so many other people you guys probably don't know about.
Yeah, I know all those ones. Lauren might not, so you
no,
gotta
no.
tell her.
I just smile and say, okay, that's me too.
They're all drummers, don't worry.
Okay, yeah, figured that.
A big thing, I'm always Dan Auerbach from Black Keys.
Yeah.
He's my thing. And then I always love Muse because they're so ahead of their time. Like, you know, they started the whole kind of like synths kind of like.
You were the first person to ever bring up Muse.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
You are the first.
I love Muse so
Muse
much.
You're my
and,
favorite.
And actually, like, a band I've been getting into lately a lot is the 1975.
They're so good.
I really like
I
that
I love
band.
The 1975.
They're really good.
I just went and saw Young the Giant last...
Oh, really?
Friday.
Oh, I love Young and
Jeremy. And it was one of the most amazing concerts. They don't have a big stage performance. That's not their thing. That's not their thing. But he is pitch perfect. He did not miss a single note.
I saw them like on like... I think it was like
I saw him at the Palladium
Jay Leno
too.
Or something. Yeah. He has like three different microphones that all have different
effects. Yeah, he has a retro mic, he has a normal mic, and they all it's hooked really up, cool. and one on the keyboard, and it's all hooked up to a pad so he can do his own effects. And he is one of the only singers I've heard that is pitch perfect.
Yeah, he's really good.
And it was my first time being in a pit because I'm small. So I actually got my way to the front at the gate, and it was the best moment of my life because I'm like, I just got through a crowd of people.
I don't think people are going to be moshing during like cough syrup or anything.
Oh, I would. So good. I'd do it.
My body got pretty crazy because he crowd surfed. He jumped in and did the whole crowd surfing.
Wait, what? Who?
The lead singer of Young the Giant.
Oh. Okay, you said my body crowd surfed. I was like, your body's different.
No, the song My Body.
My head was here, my body.
Because it was their encore, and he went and did a crowd surfing thing, and everyone was like really heavily punching each other.
Dude!
Well, you guys released your EP in October, Wasting Time. We talked a little bit about that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was, yeah, we released that.
Oh, yeah, that thing.
That thing.
Oh,
yeah.
All right.
Yeah. That's enough said.
Next question.
I just remember it was October 5th. We played the Roxy. That's my brother's.
I was there. Birthday. That was sick.
That was a really fun show. Fun.
Didn't we play?
No, because it was my brother's birthday.
I'm pretty sure we played, though.
I think.
Not that show, because it was my brother's birthday.
I'm almost positive we did.
I think the last time we played the Roxy, you guys were with us.
Yeah.
Oh.
Because it was we wanted to go, but it was my brother's birthday. My mom said,
I have your EP. I have three of them.
Oh.
I don't even have one.
You have three copies of the same EP?
Yes. I don't. I'm. By the way, they're going to be on sale on eBay. Just letting you know.
Yes. Because he took my copy, so.
It's probably true.
Well, we played one of your songs in the beginning of the intro of our show. Would you talk a little bit about Go Away?
Oh, God. Go away.
Go away.
I have a feeling the song has personal meaning.
It's very personal.
Yeah. We started writing it. We started crying. And,
yeah, and we all held hands.
Yeah. We're very emotional together.
Watched the Notebook together.
And cuddled.
Yeah.
No, it's just, you know, just go away. It's like such a broad name. Though. Yeah. It's like, just go away. It's just, you know, typical girl thing where it's like you're with another girl. And then another girl tempts you, and then you're like, go away.
Oh, okay. Like I thought it was more things. Like a breakup. You're just like, go away.
Oh, that's kind of mean.
Leave me alone.
It was more like you're with another girl, and then a girl tries tempting you to go to that way.
Yeah,
the dark side.
Go away.
I get it
but
now.
But you can't go away. That's the thing. That's hard. Yeah.
Well, we have a little special segment that we like to do called How Well Do You Know Your Band Member? Oh, Cameron has done this before.
Well, we know each other pretty well.
You guys have not. The rest of you haven't. So I have questions about each other that you guys have to answer. So, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Cameron, what is Taylor's favorite TV show?
You watch TV?
I don't usually watch TV.
Watch TV?
Walking Dead?
Is it The Walking Dead?
Yeah, it is.
The Walking Dead.
Walking Dead, got it. All right. Taylor, what is Michael's favorite junk food?
I thought you said drug food.
Cocaine.
Cocaine-a-cola.
What would your favorite
junk food? Don't worry, it's G-rated.
All right, we know each other so well. What is this?
Favorite junk food.
I guess your favorite would be...
junk food as in like
yeah,
anything unhealthy. Just anything unhealthy.
Taco Bell.
Oh,
yeah, that's it.
All right.
Beefy 5-layer, no sour cream. Three of them.
Oh, snap. He even knows the order.
Michael, who is Cameron's celebrity crush?
Ooh, Cameron's celebrity crush.
Think.
Let's see.
Think it.
Probably Harry Styles.
What does that mean? What does that symbol mean?
Kate Upton.
Oh. I was asking.
There's a video of her dugging on YouTube.
Oh,
you guys should check it out.
Oh, my God.
Doing what?
No, she's
dugging,
doing the cat
I've
daddy.
Seen it.
She's doing
seen
the
it.
Cat
oh, she's
daddy.
Doing the cat daddy. My bad.
Or the staring contest.
It's very appropriate. She's very.
That's
she's
fun.
Wearing modest clothing. It's very appropriate.
Yeah. All right.
Cam,
long sleeve shirt.
Turtleneck
with khaki.
She's kind of wearing like
pants.
A nun outfit.
Cameron, Michael's favorite movie.
The Notebook.
Is it true?
Yes.
Wow.
No, it's Pitch Perfect. It's actually his dad's favorite movie. Every time I'm at his house, his dad's watching Pitch Perfect in the other room. So funny.
That's amazing. Yeah. All right, we got two more. Taylor, what's Cameron's favorite soda?
He literally does not drink soda.
You drink water?
Yeah.
He likes Arrowhead. That's his favorite water.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Arrowhead and Fiji.
Fine. Okay.
Arrowhead is the great. It is.
Come on.
What's the difference between water?
Whoever likes Dasani.
I can tell all the difference between waters. I'm really weird like that.
Me too. That's right. I'm a water
person. Arrowhead is just
too.
Like pure. It's like so anything good. Besides Arrowhead and like Fiji, you can taste chemicals.
Okay, who likes Dasani? Raise your hand if you like Dasani.
Dasani
is that problem with Arrowhead.
I tried Arrowhead.
Dasani
is
there's something there.
Are we really arguing about water right now?
Yes, we are. We're starting.
I am very sensitive about my water.
Fiji is like good because it's like soft.
Has anyone had Voss water?
Oh, no,
Voss is good. I've never had Voss.
Smart water.
Yeah.
If it's not smart water's good.
Smart
too.
Water's smart like Aquafina. Water.
If it's like not glass, water. It's not good.
All right, last one. Michael, what's the most embarrassing thing on Taylor's iPod?
Oh, no. Oh, gosh.
Figure skating.
Figure skating. I think the most embarrassing thing on his iPod or iPhone.
Oh.
It's the same thing.
Well.
Let's make it broader. Let's make it his iPhone. Let's just make it bigger, because iPod's just songs, but on a phone, there's so many possibilities.
Does it have to be about him?
No, just...
Oh, all right. That picture with him with his straight hair.
Well, there is a picture of Cameron in his underwear.
Yeah. There's actually a video of him going through my house in his underwear, and
right,
my mom's...
let's not bring this up.
All right. He's like, all right, we're done.
It was a
I'm
dare.
Out. We're not going to talk about it anymore. So you guys have a big show coming up next week at the Vault.
February 15th.
Which we're going to give tickets away for. So we're giving away 3 tickets. So if you guys tweet us
what
at
a deal.
TMP Music Project and Colorblind RB.
No.
We will give you free tickets. So...
sweet.
First three people who tweet us will give you tickets. And my band Daring Violet's playing
both
as well.
Enter.
So
yes. Free tickets.
See.
Both enter.
And Juicebox Bandits and Galvanized Souls.
It's going to be a fun
date
show.
Is that?
Yeah.
It's next
February 15th.
Saturday.
Yeah.
Wow. That week's going to be crazy because
playing the same
I'm going,
show date as me.
I have a 4-day weekend that day.
Me too. I'm going
me too.
I'm going to Imagine Dragons on Friday. I'm doing the show at the Vault on Saturday.
I was trying to get tickets for that show.
I'm so excited. They have a show on Sunday morning, and then I'm seeing Panic at the Disco Sunday night. So I'm like, it's music weekend, guys.
Yes, Lauren has an insane
music
weekend.
I'm going to cry.
I'm
going
to sleep and eat Cheetos or something.
Spicy Cheetos.
Yep.
That's the best.
Yep.
So are you guys working on new music, even though you had your EP just come out?
Yeah, we're actually, we were working on stuff yesterday up in Malibu, or actually Topanga Canyon.
If you want to get specific, guys.
It's Topanga Canyon. Yeah. We're just going to kind of like remaster.
Remaster?
Remaster like a couple of our stuff that was on our EP, and then we're working on 2 new ones.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah.
So
that's great.
How much time do we have right now? A while? I'm going to just go for it.
We got about 5 minutes.
All right, sweet. So speaking of like you guys writing songs and whatnot, how do you, you know, do that? Like, do you guys write as a band? Who comes up with lyrics and whatnot? So you guys willing to share that?
We try to get
every time.
It's different every time. Like this last time, we got the instrumentation done first, and then we put words on top of it.
Yeah,
it's,
that's how we usually start. If we get like the music down, then the words, because it's easier to like once you have a melody in mind, it's easier to get some lyrics going.
Well, but you guys all write the words though.
Yes.
And do you all write together? Like you just sit down in a room and be like, let's write a song right now.
Actually, that usually doesn't work too well.
Well, Cameron has a man cave, so we like. Yeah. Chill out in his man cave and
dude, I want
to
do
try
that.
To think of a lyric.
Get a man cave.
What's your man cave look like?
I'm a man cave.
It's like, I can have a man
it
cave.
It says
you
man
can
cave.
Have man
actually, yeah, it says man cave. It has like a projector in
oh,
it.
Oh, that's awesome.
Wait, does it really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And has like license plates everywhere.
Mini fridge.
Mini fridge.
I want
it just
a man
needs
cave.
A bathroom. That's all it needs.
That's what I want.
If it has
never,
a bathroom,
you'll
never
leave again. Dude, so at my house, I have a studio, which is pretty nice, but we have this Fender refrigerator. It's like a Fender. It looks like an amp. But you open it and it's
that's
a fridge.
Awesome.
Oh, that's sweet.
It's so cool. Yeah, right?
Because if you have food, bathroom, drink, TV, never have to leave.
Yeah, we're good.
Maybe Grand Theft Auto 5.
Oh, and we have amps and a drum set in there, so we're good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got all your music, everything in just one place.
Oh, we have snacks, too.
Set yeah, we have a lot
life.
Of snacks.
Dude, I want to come over.
You're welcome.
You sold me at the snacks.
Well, we want to thank you guys so much for coming on. But before we go, can you give us all your social media sites so people can find you and any upcoming shows you guys have besides The Vault on the 15th?
All right. We're on Twitter at ColorblindRB.
Yeah.
Yes.
For Redondo Beach.
And the same thing for Instagram, right?
Yeah, Instagram, ColorblindRB. Facebook, Colorblind RB.
iTunes, Colorblind RB.
Yes.
Yeah, it's just Colorblind RB for everything.
Awesome.
Yeah. And then do you have any other shows besides The Vault?
Yes.
We have the Lighthouse coming up.
I thought you said the White House. I was like, what?
Yeah. Obama, like, asked for us. He's like...
Lighthouse, February 21st.
Yeah.
It's in Hermosa Beach.
From 6 to 8.
So it's a really cool place. You guys will like it. I know you will.
Yeah, it's just like a kind of like chill place to play, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's
awesome. Fun. Awesome. Well, I think we're going to leave with your guys' song, It's Not the End.
It's Not the End.
All right. Let's play this.
They will try to tear you down. No one is around. It feels like you're gonna drown. But I know what it's like to be on the outside, to live a lie.
I love the extended outro that's just like the random picking just to end it.
I don't think they realize we're back on the air.
They're talking about headphones and stuff. Anyway, we are back with the awesome Kenton Duty.
Ah, please. The awesome, magnificent.
Wonderful.
Don't go on, please. Continue.
Oh, please. Continue.
Longest intro ever of compliments.
Yeah, right. Just keep going. Anyway.
We get paid to do this. No. How are you doing today?
I'm good. Had a nice drive over. It's a beautiful day out. Sunny California.
You know. As awake you can be on a Sunday morning.
Yes. Well, thank you for coming to our studio.
It's cloudy.
Yes. Talking
it's
with us.
It's cloudy.
We last saw you at Winter Lights in December. So, you know, we heard you went home for the holidays.
I did.
So,
I was home for a month.
How was being home in Texas?
It was nice. It's the longest I've been there in probably 7 years.
Wow.
So it was very nice to be home. And I took my sister to school.
Can you really call it home anymore?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Home is where the heart is, man.
Exactly.
My work
I'm
is out
down
here.
With that.
That was deep.
Home is Texas.
Isn't that a Campbell's commercial?
Shh. Everybody listening right now is like, dang.
I feel like I'm listening to Buddha.
Well, it's funny because we went to our meeting beforehand. I've just found out you were on Lost. Mm-hmm. And I about Bob because we used to watch that show all the time when I was like,
me too,
9, 10, didn't even know. It was like,
oh yeah,
funny little story.
I was at Comic-Con a couple years ago and one of the ladies from Lost was there. Mm-hmm. I don't know what that
Starma.
Is
does it look familiar?
Yes, you do.
Yay! That is awesome.
That's awesome. Anyway, so I saw the lady from Lost there and I walk up to her and I'm like, hey, can you tell me how Lost ends? And she looks at me, she's like, you haven't seen it yet? And I was like, yes, I have. And I ran away.
That's great.
That was embarrassing.
That's a good response. I'm going to start using that.
You haven't
well, like,
seen
no,
it
no, we all get asked, and like, the directors don't even know.
Yeah.
No.
Two people in the world know, and it's our executive producers.
Yeah, because they, you didn't know, when they think of it, it's end? Like all in their head.
Didn't it end?
Yeah.
It did it.
Yeah. Or is
yeah,
it,
that's
or
what
is
I thought.
Like, oh, under
I think
and
Lost
ends.
Was the original Inception.
Yes.
Yeah, wait, what?
I mean, let's put it that way.
I think Lost just went under a different name at a different time.
Smart
on a different
phones come in handy for a lot of things.
And like,
Lauren, yeah.
Weren't they like all in the church when it ended? Like,
yeah, wasn't Lost purgatory? Like,
that's what I thought it was.
Well,
it was
okay. I don't know.
Lost, the ending of Lost is up to your own interpretation because yeah. Vince Gilligan will never actually reveal what it is because he enjoys torturing people.
What the? That sounds like a horrible TV show.
Yeah.
God. I mean, Walking Dead is clearly much better.
Not even Breaking Bad.
Yes. It comes on tonight. I'm so excited.
Well, it's so funny because like we stopped watching at some point because just life got crazy. But I remember seeing previews and fixing my mic there. And I remember it's like they got off the island. It's like, we have to go back to the island.
Yes.
And I was like, okay, I lost it. I can't do this.
Lost
anymore.
It.
All right.
Thank you.
But,
back to you.
Back to music.
Yes.
Well, you've been very busy with movies lately. You went from Shake It Up, and now you've been doing a lot of movies. You just finished the Cartoon Network's contest, right?
I actually saw that on air the other day.
Yes.
What? Adam's having
it was
a,
also, I saw on demand.
He's having a lot of Inception moments right now.
Yeah, I know. Dream were you the weird, the foreign
the
dude on
Shake It Up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Can you do the accent for
him? Never.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
This is weird now.
Did it take you a long time to, like, work on that? Or is it just something
I had
like,
the
hey,
accent from before the audition process. And then
where'd the accent come from?
Well, I'm an older brother, and when you're an older brother, you have to come up with a lot of different ways to keep your little siblings entertained.
Or annoy them, depending on the age.
I choose to entertain, because then, you know, it doesn't come back to bite me later in life.
That's true.
I'm you know, basically putting in bank geez. Time right I now. Should. Yeah. Making deposits of laughter.
There you go.
So the accent came from that, and then a show, you know, happened, and suddenly it's now this worldwide known accent that nobody really knows what it might be. It's its own Lost thing.
When you went into the audition the first time, did you use the accent or did they ask you to use an accent?
They wanted a nondescript European accent. So there were people there with French, normal German, my German, Russian, Italian, Irish thing that I had going.
And of course, that was the best, right?
And of course, you know.
Of course it was.
I was the one who got the job. No, it was really fun because a lot of my good friends were up for the part as well. And so when you're sitting in the Disney building hanging out for multiple hours in one day, it's always nice to know the other people there.
Yes.
Because then you're like, if I don't get it, you better get it.
Yes,
yeah, because then you're totally. Like, I believe in you.
Yeah.
It's going to be you.
Mm-hmm. So did Disney ever go, what is that? Like, did they?
Oh, yeah.
They were
oh,
like,
yeah.
What is
plenty
this?
Of times. They're like, I don't know what's going on, but we like it.
We like it.
See, that's great.
Yeah, and then, you know, Caroline learned the accent. And it's actually
oh my
funny.
Gosh. Did you teach it to her?
I had it, yeah. And if you go back and watch the first three episodes, if you watch it like 3 and then 1 and 2, that's the order we filmed it in.
Oh, okay.
So you'll actually see
the accent getting better.
It like just her creating it as her own.
I love it.
Gotcha.
Because mine's more German based and hers more Russian based. So it's like.
Well, I remember my little brother went in for, I think it was the part of your little cousin or nephew or something. Mm-hmm. And we went to that chalk after dinner thing like 2 or 3 years ago. And I was like, he's going to play like your cousin or something. I forget what the part was, or uncle, or I forget what it was.
I think he was my cousin.
Yeah, I think it was cousin.
It's really sad when you don't remember
right?
an episode.
So I was like, my
and
cousin.
And like people come up to you, hey, remember that time you, and you're like, yes, of course.
Of course, yeah.
I totally do.
But no, I told Mike, I was like, go ask him, he'll teach you the accent. And I remember he's like, I just talked to Gunter. I'm like, yeah. And he's like, that was like the best day of his life. Awesome. So I was like, because he was probably like 5 or 6 at the time. Yes. So he was just like perfect. Ecstatic with that.
Which, what's really funny to me is like a lot of, and I didn't realize it before, but because I was never that kid.
Yeah.
But a lot of like young kids just believe that's who you are. So I met, like, my grandmother took me one of her good friends does her hair. So she goes, took me to the salon and her sons were there and they got, all they wanted for Christmas were Hess and Heifer shirts. And Disney doesn't make Hess and Heifer shirts. So their moms made Hess and Heifer shirts. So they did it like with skulls and crossbones for their letters. So they're like,
that's
they were
awesome. Cool.
They were like, oh, dude, like, check this out.
And then after that, Disney had to get on their A game and make Hess and Heifer.
They still haven't. But
Disney, come on.
I know. There's a lot really of money to be gotten on that. There.
I would buy a Hess and
Heifer. Just like a different letter on every shirt.
They freaked out.
Yeah.
Because they're like, they couldn't talk to me. Like, they ran to the back of the salon. And, you know, I leave. You know, I've had some headshots and stuff for them. I leave. And later that night when I'm home, my grandmother calls me and she goes, I just found out why they were so, like, why they wouldn't talk to you. And I'm like, what is it? Because I'm, like, double their size? And they go, no. They thought you'd come out of the TV.
Oh, my God.
Like, they came home, turned on TiVo, and they went, Gunther's back in the TV. And so they really thought, like, I'd come out of the TV. And so, like,
how old were they?
They were 6 and 4.
Okay.
Aww. So I'm like, if I'd thought I'd come out of the TV, I'd be pretty scared too.
Yeah. Yeah. I used to think that with Raven. I used to think like actors went on TV and just did the same thing over and over again. Like I thought it was like all live.
Oh, yeah.
Because like you watch American Idol, it's all live TV. So I was like, okay, Disney Channel's live too. So I'm like, Raven just, you know, changes her outfits and does the whole episode. Exactly.
That'd be so exhausting. Horrible. If that was true. Can you think about that?
Horrible.
Like, and if your show was did a marathon and then reruns, that's a 24-hour day. Easy.
Oh, that's horrible.
You only get commercial breaks to take naps.
Yeah. I just want to sleep right now.
Where's my food? All of this is plastic.
Yes. Well, we were talking about the contest before we went on talking about your accent. Tell us a little bit about that movie because it has like such a strong message behind it.
You're right. It has a very anti-bullying message to it, and that's what actually brought me to want to be a part of the film. Was I read the script and I got very attached to it very quickly, and I was like, I really want to do this, and we became a family on that set. I mean, we're in a small town in New York. I think there was 2 actual restaurants and then like a Jack in the Box and Taco Bell mix.
Wow.
So like
a lot of
3
Taco Bell.
3 all together. I ate at the diner most of the time, and then there was an Italian restaurant that where we had our celebrations like weekly. We were there for a month and it felt like 4 just because we were having so much fun. Time went by really quick. It was an awesome time. I had to gain weight so I could actually be a bully rather than this lanky guy.
What did you eat?
A lot of food.
Just a lot.
I worked out twice
food.
A day. I ate probably my own body weight in food.
My gosh.
Swam as part separate from working out, and then did school on top of that because I was still in school.
Wow.
So like, it was a very busy day, every day. But it paid off because I actually now I'm a pretty good swimmer. I should say.
There you go.
I could easily save somebody.
I could. Like, I could. Like Danny in the film, which I did. Haha. But funny story about that scene of me diving in and getting him out of the water is we had to shoot it at least 12 times with just the POV shot. So I was diving in, grabbing a full-sized man, DP, with a camera.
God.
And he had sandbags on, and then swimming him out with the one-arm carry. And then dragging him to the side.
Wow.
He'd hand off the water camera. I'd get out, and we'd start again.
Holy moly.
And we did that at least 12 times because we're just like, it just doesn't feel right. And I'm like, I know it doesn't feel right to me either. It's like you just see this blur. Like there's no air bubbles or anything.
Really?
And so I was like, all right. I got it. So 13th take. I'm probably exaggerating by 2 or 3 of them.
But it felt like 13.
It was a lot of
takes.
That's
exhausting.
And I'm like, I'm just going to like do a really bad dive. Because like I was just like perfect dive, you know, like got to do a perfect dive.
Yeah, and it was just perfection every time.
Every time.
That's almost more tiring because you're like working on your form. You're like,
yeah,
I have
exactly.
To get this
I was just like, I got to do it right, you know, because he's this star swimmer. I have to do it right, and I was like, I'm just gonna mess it up. And it looked so cool when I did, because it's just this bubble of air coming with me, and then I just sort of came out of the bubbles, and we're like, that's the shot. That's wrap it up. We're done.
It's we're done here. Dive. We don't need anything else.
I bet at that moment you're just like, get me out of here.
Yes, exactly. Right, I was so pruny. Because the whole day we were in the pool. So, I mean, like, I looked like I'd aged maybe 5 years.
Uh-huh. I found out.
I had wrinkles in my wrinkles. Exactly.
Well, you actually, one of your songs, Breaking the Surface, is on the soundtrack.
Yeah.
So, how was that like? I think we're actually going to play it, too.
Oh, cool. Well, I met up with Peter Zizzo, and he has an awesome name. He said in college, like, the term, everybody was like, you just got zizzed if he, like, dissed you.
I love Dude. It.
I was like, that's the best.
I want that.
Right?
Someone make that about me, please. Get on it.
But I met up with him for a few days, and we did the track, then wrote the lyrics, and then recorded it in 3 days. And then I bounced back to L.A. But it was fun. We did it in New York, and sort of wrote it from, like, a water perspective, because that's a lot of what Matt goes through. He, you know, releases a lot of his emotions in the pool, you know, just like that's his calming thing. Like, yours is candles.
Yeah.
That set off fire alarms. Matt's is swimming. So we based a lot of it on water, and then he's going through a lot in the, you know, breaking his own mold. And so the breaking the surface.
Love
and
it.
So that's, yeah, awesome. That's the idea of the song.
Well, I think we should need to listen to the song.
All right.
Let's play it.
The dam's about to break down. The water's so cold. My heart is on the ground. I'm losing control. But I don't know which way to turn. Don't know which way to go. When it seems the more that I learn, it's the less that I know. When the waves are crashing me up and they're testing my will, I'll face them down. It's just a spill. Yeah, I don't drown, I just get wet. Water's up above my head. I won't drown, I'm not done yet. I'm breaking the surface. I'm breaking the surface. It's hard to see and I can't breathe. Caught in the undertow. It's dark and deep, but still I know.
Like the ending, but
I love it.
I know it by heart. I've listened to that song so many
times. I assume so. If you guys want to call in and give Kenton your questions, you can call us at 323-284-7826. All we ask is that you turn your volume down on your computer, because we can hear it in here and it's very distracting,
and we want to hear you.
Yeah.
I don't have headphones on, so feel free to leave the volume up because everybody else with the headphones.
You need a pair of headphones so you can actually hear. So
yeah, you can take mine.
Or okay, cool. So yeah, you can call us 323-284-7826. Have a question ready. You can talk to us for a little bit. So
yeah.
So until then, we got more questions for you. Stop it.
Well, you know, Kenton, you really seem like a really positive person, and like on your Facebook, you always share positive quotes, and I think that's really awesome for your fans. What do you do to stay positive?
Well, I mean, I get a text from my sisters pretty much every day, and they are the light of my life.
Aww.
So, I mean, honestly, I know, and I cherish it every day because I can't. It was never guaranteed that they would have survived birth. So one of them had the 50 up and the other had the 50 below. And they say that she only survived because I sang to her in the ICU. And I'd sung to her while she was in the womb. So they said that was what kept her moving on. So it's like
I'm about to
how
cry
old are
now.
They today?
They're 14 today. They turned 15
next
August. They're twins.
Wow.
And I named them. So, I mean, we're very close.
You named them.
I named them at four.
Wow.
At four.
My dad came home from a business trip and he goes, honey, I got this brilliant epiphany. And she goes, what is it? He goes, how about we have Kenton name the girls? That way, because I had been a only child for so long. He's like, I don't want him to feel like we're just giving up on him and moving on to somebody
else.
Forget
about you.
And so she's like, oh, I don't know. What if it comes out? I'd been really into Teletubbies at that moment.
Oh,
so she's
gosh.
Like, what if it comes out like he names them like purple and red? You know? He goes, well, then that's his nicknames for them. It's brilliant, right? And she goes, well, okay. So like they sent me off and they had me pick two boy names, two girl names, and then my favorite of both. And so I had Jefferson and Jackson and Jessica and Rebecca and then Jefferson and Jessica. And then when they actually came out, I picked which one was which.
Oh, really?
Or when they were in the womb. My dad would tell you the story a little bit better because obviously he would remember it a little bit better.
Yeah, you were four.
Because I was four.
Well, it's a good thing you didn't have that random accent then because maybe you would have named them in that accent.
Yeah, if I named them like Parushka.
Well, you're looking at like a four-year-old. You're like, okay, it's going to be Spike and Sparkles. Like,
yes. That was part of a stand-up routine, actually, those names, which is really funny. Yes, I did a stand-up routine with that. I think it was like Spike and Pitbull or something.
Oh, gosh.
But definitely Spike was one of them. So well done.
I got that like psychic thing.
Yeah, you got that with the purple hair.
Yeah,
yes.
purple hair and candles. That's all you need.
That's all you need to know. But yeah, so that's what they keep me positive. Because you know, just getting that text, hey, it lights up my day. You know, I can be having the worst day possible, and then
you're like so much better.
I know, it's awesome.
That's so sweet. So now you've just been performing all over the place. What has been some of your favorite places? And you performed on a turkey float at Thanksgiving too, which I think is amazing.
Yes.
What was that like?
That was awesome. Turkey and it was, the best part was like I had some an elderly couple sitting up top. Like if you look at the picture on my Twitter, which is my profile now, like you see this older couple just sitting up top, and they're like the guests of honor for the parade. And I'm the lead float. And my parents, when they saw them go up, I'm like, I hope they're just like inspecting it. Cause like it's one of the songs that's just like very, very hyped.
Yeah.
And you're just like, woo, the whole time.
Gosh.
And like the cheerleaders in front, by the time we'd done the song once, now had a routine to it.
Oh, wow.
And it was like, so that was fun for me because I'm just sort of watching and I have like my helpers and they're all having a good time. And then you look in front and there's a choreographed routine.
Wow.
Happening to the beat. And it's.
And they did have that part too.
As far as I know.
And they're pro cheerleaders.
They are pro. Exactly. Boy, thank you.
And also they're cheerleaders.
And also they're cheerleaders. So I felt very cheery.
Woo, lots of pep.
But they came, they were dancing. When we were on air, like on camera, like they were up there going, like it's grooving,
awesome. Like that.
That's what my mom told me. That's the motion she gave me that they were doing. But then like, they got when the parade was done and they got down, they're like, we loved your song. Is it on iTunes yet? Where can we go get it? I'm like, one, why do you know about iTunes? And two, not yet, but I'll let you know.
Wait, what do you mean? Why do you know about iTunes?
Because like. What, like they pull out their iPhones, like they're pulling, like they pulled up iTunes. I didn't even know how to get that far yet. I didn't have an iPhone yet, so I was very confused. This was 2 years ago.
Okay.
Yeah, 2 years ago. So I was very impressed because I had no idea how to get that far to iTunes, And they're already like looking me up. They're like, we don't see anything yet. Like, it's all this Disney stuff. And I'm like, well, yeah, I'm on Disney. Yeah, they're like, oh, our grandchildren must watch you. I go, yes. Yes, they probably do.
I thought you were talking about the cheerleaders.
No. No.
I was like, what's, how is
when
that?
When I said grandchildren, like, man, these cheerleaders.
Yeah, that's wow, when it clicked. Like, I was like, cheerleaders, grandchildren, nope, can't be them.
Unless they're really old cheerleaders.
Which then it's even more impressive.
That, yes.
That would
yes.
be.
Because I was exhausted by the end of the parade. Think about doing that. At, you know, oh,
imagine walking it. Like,
oh, no.
Walking.
Yeah, you, oh, didn't, no. you got to ride.
Yeah, I rode on a float, jumping around on a float, and then I got in a golf cart.
Oh, that's fine.
There you go.
Yeah, I had the prime sense of travel going on.
I want a backflip in a go-kart. Or a golf cart. That's it.
That'd yes, cool. It was a golf cart. It wasn't a go-kart.
My so, bad. As we get ready to wrap up, do you have any shows coming up or where people
yes.
can catch you?
Yes, I do. The nearest show is at the Infusion Lounge on the 25th.
Awesome.
So, yeah, there's multiple bands performing, of which, like, I Am Five, Dream, Andrew, The Dolls, myself, Mandy Rain, and then Ochoa Boys, my boys.
Boys.
We just did
They're
their
so
we just
funny.
Did their music video, and you can actually go, like, I think I just retweeted it last night, but they just put out the teaser for it.
Oh, awesome!
I act in it. It's quite an awesome video, if I do say so myself. It took us 2 days to shoot. We had a bunch of fans that came and partied it up with us, and so yeah, definitely look
I'm sure
forward
they love
to
that.
That. It was a good time. It was a good time.
Wow. Well, and also, can you give everyone your social media sites
yes.
so they can find you?
Yes. My Twitter is at Kenton J. Duty. My Instagram is at Dreamers King. Facebook is Kenton Duty Official or something. Is that what it is?
I think
I
so.
Believe you.
I think that's we'll what tag it. Is. It.
Well,
worry.
They'll tag it. You got it. Yeah. You know, don't take my word for it. I'm the blonde after next to the mic, so.
Well, before we go, Adam, will you show everyone the amazing thing I made for your birthday? I made chocolate mustaches that I'm giving away to people. And I just want to show these off because I'm so proud of these.
Yay!
Snaps. There
Snaps
you go.
Snaps for the chocolate mustaches.
I like that you're actually wearing it as well. That is...
Yes.
You are what you eat.
Well, I think we're going to leave with
your
song.
Well, November just ended.
Best Night Ever? No.
Summer Night.
Summer Night.
Summer Night.
All right. Thank you guys
it's
so Joe much.
It's Joe Boy's favorite song.
All right. Here
Thank
we go.
Thank you, Ken.
See you guys next week.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. I saw you with your friends last night.
Oh, yeah.
You were amazingly hot.
Ooh, la, la.
Now, don't you know you're just my type?
Oh, yeah.
Ha. Whether you like it or not, hey baby, you and I could be like summertime. White tank tops and shades. Hey baby, you and I could be like summertime. Water guns and lemonade. So if you're pretty and you know it, clap your hands. Kick back, don't let the party end. Not tryna be your man, just wanna be more than friends. You're putting on a show and baby, I'm your biggest fan. If you're pretty and you know it, clap your hands. Where you at? Party started at 10. Cause when the music's up loud, stars come out. Know what happens when the sun goes down.
Teenage summer nights,
yeah.
They won't last forever. Let's sit by the fire,
yeah.
And cuddle up together. It's just you and I,
huh.
We can do whatever. Teenage summer nights,
hey.
Can't get no better. Feel alive. Not to smile, hey baby, you
hey.
I could be like summertime, writing love notes in the sand. Hey, hey baby, you I could be like summertime, share the moment on Instagram. So if you're pretty and you know it, clap your hands. Kick back, don't let the party end. Not trying to be your man, just wanna be more than friends. You're putting on a show, and baby, I'm your biggest fan. If you're pretty and you know it, clap your hands. Where you at? Party started at 10. Cause when the music's up loud, the stars come out. Know what happens when the sun goes down.
Teenage summer nights,
yeah.
They won't last forever. Let's sit by the fire,
yeah.
together, it's just you and I. We can do whatever, teenage summer nights. Hey! Can't get no better, feeling like home. Kick it on the beach. You seen a lot of